Episode 1829, Does the Day of the Week Dictate Your Daily Success?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a
stop sign, watching happy day. It is a brand new week, which means what? You get to set the tempo. You get to set the rhythm of how you're going to live out this week. But I got a question for you. Does the day of the week dictate your daily success? Let's dive in. It is Mindset Monday. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Yes, it is up and coming. Pay attention to hear. You are going to want to be in the know on this. You're going to hear it first on the podcast and then with our new designed and revised newsletter. I know we've kind of had a few of them out there, but you know what? We're revising everything. I should say I'm revising everything, and we will have all the information out there too. So there's the only two ways you'll be able to find out more information about the AIM Academy. It's your community and you're going to want to lock it in. Further, I am sure you have heard about the Australian fires. Australia, we are praying for you. But I want to invite each of you that if you are in the financial position to be able to donate to those who are out there helping, go to the Red Cross if you're not sure. Reach out. They need our help and support. We're thinking of you. We're praying for you. God, bring the rain and stop these fires. All right. Are you ready? It is Mindset Monday. We got to dive in. Rise and shine. It is Monday. What you do today will either move you closer to your goals or farther away. But what if it was Thursday? Does the day of the week dictate your daily success? Well, how many times have you heard people exclaim, "Oh, it's Monday," with a dreaded tone in their voice? Probably too many, including you and definitely me. Oh yes, no one wants to get up on Monday. Your friend in the morning becomes the snooze button. How many times did you hit it today? Well, you know what? For me personally, that's what I have worked on in the past, getting up and not hitting that snooze button. But when it becomes your friend, you get into what? A habit. Oh, yes, I know. There's that word again. We don't like the word habit, at least when it goes against to what we're really wanting to work towards. When you hit that snooze button, then it's what? A domino effect of what happens throughout your day. You're stuck, rushed to finish the day, just to what? Barely get through. And that's how we start our week. That doesn't sound like a great way to start. We get up with an attitude attached to the day of the week and hit snooze. But what if Monday was Tuesday? Would that change your Tuesday? Would it look like a Monday since it's now no longer a Tuesday, but a Monday? And how would that make your Monday? Would your Monday be better since it's really on a Tuesday, but it's called Monday? Okay, I know that's a lot to think about and to process. It just tells you how my mind works. It goes in circles. Most of us do not stop long enough to think about how we attach ourselves to the days of the week. And there are no specific stats on this. However, the studies on productivity say that an average worker in an 8-hour workday is productive for about 3 hours. That's their prime time, 3 hours out of 8 hours. Yet that's when you want to show up. They're not saying when you're complaining and you're tired and you're sick and you're exhausted and you're flustered and you're dealing with, you know, the CRAP of life. They're not talking about all that stuff. They're just talking about when you're there from 8 hours, you only get 3 hours of productivity. So what happens when you go home and you have all these other responsibilities? Do you think you get much done then? If you only have 3 hours then, probably not, because what? Your prime time is already gone. If you add in your attitude towards the day, what do you think happens with your productivity overall? Of course it goes down. You don't get as much done for whatever reason you have conjured up in your head. What you think about, you believe. You've probably heard what you think about, you bring about. Well, what you think about, if you're thinking about it over and over and over and over again, you're going to believe it, right? If blue is actually the color purple and you tell yourself long enough that even when you look at the color blue, that it's purple, do you think eventually you will say it's purple? Yes. What if you were told 2 + 2 = 5 and you learned it from the very beginning? It would take a lot to convince you that 2 + 2 = 4. But you see, that's what we're doing with the days of our week. We are sitting there with a label. And how unfair is that to Monday? How unfair is it to have Monday labeled as a dreaded Monday? I love Dan Miller. He wrote this book, No More Dreaded Mondays. And I think about that not even as his title of his book or the book itself. It's a great book. I would encourage you to read it. But what it gets me thinking is that, wait a minute, no more dreaded Mondays. I shouldn't have to dread my Monday anyway. I shouldn't have to dread my Tuesday, my Wednesday, my Thursday, my Friday, my Saturday, or my Sunday. I'm going to get out of it what I put into it. What you think about, you believe. You are giving your thoughts life. That's what happens. If you dread Mondays and are always complaining about how tired and bummed you are because of the day, it's the day, then you will have that kind of day. You're going to be bummed. You're going to be tired, right? You know the quote by Jim Rohn, you're the average of the 5 people you spend the most time with. Okay, think about that. Really think about that for a moment. You are the average of the 5 people you spend the most time with. So think about those 5 people. But what about the 6th person? You. You are your biggest influencer. There's no one bigger in your life than you. Remember, what you think about, you believe. So if you're the average of the 5 people you spend the most time with, you can't forget the most number one before those 5 even come into count. And that's you. You have to get out of the dreaded Monday effect and get into the game of persuasion. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Play the game of persuasion. Dr. Wayne Dyer says this, if you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. I'm going to say that again, because this is something that we don't stop and think about. We don't think about, okay, how do I really feel about Monday? When someone says the word Monday to you, what immediately comes to your mind? When someone says Sunday to you, what immediately comes to your mind? Now, most of us are going to attach it to what? An activity that is a responsibility or is something that we do every single time that day comes up. So if you go to church on Sunday and I say Sunday, probably what pops in your head is we go to church. Now for us, we go to church on Saturday. So if somebody says Saturday, I'm thinking time with family and church. That's just how we do it. Now when you say Sunday, it's all about family. I mean, that's just family, hands down. And then I do stuff around the work. It's just kind of my day of reflection and rejuvenation, restoration for my soul. I try not to put myself in a position that I have to do something. Now, there are a few times that I do that, like Christmas, when I'm decorating. And I'm like, okay, I really need to get this done so I can sit down and enjoy it for the rest of the season. There are those times. But as a whole, you know, my Sunday is my restoration day, my rejuvenation. When you say Mondays, it's like, okay, we're going in. It's going to be awesome. We've got a brand new day, the start of the week. Now, I think Sundays are the start of the week, but for Mondays, for school week is what I'm thinking. And so already in my head, I'm like, okay, planning. We get up and we've got a routine. I'm up at 4. I go to bed. At least I'm in bed, I hope, and try to be by 9-ish. Usually it's more like 10 to 11-ish, but I do my best to get there. If you change the way you look at things, the things you look at will change. If I was to look at Sundays as the day that I go to church, because that's the day I go to church, then it would be totally different than looking at it how I perceive it now, because I'm doing things differently. When you attach your attitude, perceptions, and expectations to the day of the week, your daily success and failures are impacted. If you want to play the game of persuasion to benefit your goals, then you have to ask yourself the following questions, right? Let's get real here. How do I define each day of the week? That is the first question. How do you define Sunday? When I say Sunday, what do you think of? When I say Monday, what do you think of? I mean, some people already are thinking, oh my gosh, I have to get up. I've got to make 3 lunches and then I've got to make sure I have them to school by 7:30 so they can make it into class by 7:45. And then we have basketball practice and then we have cheer practice and then we have wrestling practice. And then I have to go back and pick them up from the activities, and oh, I've got to coach too, and oh, by the way, somewhere in all of that, I've got to clean the house, do the laundry, make dinner, so then I can start again on Tuesday. Oh, but Tuesday, you mentioned Tuesday, right? This is what goes on in our mind in split milliseconds. But we don't stop long enough to really think about, how do I define each day of the week? Because if you sit there and go, oh, it's Monday. Well, that doesn't sound very exciting. Ah, it's Monday. I cannot wait for Monday. Wouldn't that be awesome to say that every single day? Now, some of you, it's just not your personality. I get it. You don't have to be a morning person to feel good about the day. But you have to define the day. Know what you're doing. Know how you're saying, gosh, do I have a smiley face on every day? Or if I was to attach an emoji, what would that look like? Would it even make sense? Would I have, you know, a face with my tongue sticking out? Would I have just a very sad face? Would I have this mean or red grimace, like anger, like I'm just gonna... What would it be? Now, when you think about how you define each day of the week, then I want you to name them specifically. Write down your presumptions, your expectations, your attitudes. What are they? Be specific. And for you, maybe you find out that it's only a couple days of the week that are affected. Maybe it's every single day of the week. What is it? And when you write these down, you may almost possibly note that, wait, it's not how I perceive it, but it's how my spouse perceives it or how my children perceive it. Oh yes, my baby G-man, I'm telling you what. He sits there and goes, oh mom, already yesterday. I got this week. I got 2 quizzes. I got a test. I got to write a paper, a 400-page paper. I got 42 minutes to write it tomorrow morning. I'm like, what? That's what he tells me. And all of a sudden, you can hear in his voice the anxiety going up and up and up and up and up and up and up. And it's not anxiety for an excitement. It's like, oh, dreaded Monday already. And I'm like, whoa, snap out of this, dude. It's going to be a great week. You're going to bed. You're going to be refreshed. It's going to be awesome. But if you don't see it that way, if you don't believe it that way, then it's not going to be that way. So write down how you define each day of the week right now, how you look at it. Number 2, how do I want to feel each day of the week? Now, notice this is written differently, right? The question is, how do I feel each day of the week? Most of us can't really look at our schedule and say, well, you know, I've got this, 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 and this, and then I got, well, I can't change half of it. Okay, fine. Start with how you want to feel. Define that. What is it? Do you want to feel energized? Do you want to feel joy? Do you just want to feel like, hey, I can wake up and not feel like I'm going to bite somebody's head off. Okay, that's kind of good, right? Write down how you want to feel each day of the week. And then 3, what is one thing you can do to assist in feeling that way each day of the week? So if you're like, okay, I want to have joy and I don't want to be extra stressed, but man, my Tuesdays are jam-packed. Well, guess what? Maybe something needs to go on Tuesday. Maybe you need to, you know, look at it and say, oh man, it really is jam-packed. I need to take a couple things off. So not only are you looking at your schedule as to, okay, will this work within how I want to feel when I think about my Tuesdays, but you're also saying, okay, I control my schedule. And so I can make changes. So therefore, I can enjoy my day differently. That's important. Most of us think that we don't have control of our days. And ultimately, we do. And if you say, oh, no, my kids are in all these activities, I don't have control. Oh, no. Mama, you have control. You are allowing them. You are paying for them. You are giving them permission. You are signing them up to go do all those activities. If you don't think it's right for your child, then why are you letting them do it? If you don't think it's right for you, if you don't think it's right for the season of life, you need to have these conversations. Yes, I'm being real here on a Monday because I love you. Because I'm actually tired of people just griping all the time about, oh my gosh, if I just could. Stop about if I just could and do. Make the changes needed. If you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Some things need to be canceled out. Some things you need to say no to. Other things you need to see, instead of seeing the color blue, you see the color purple. You paint it differently. Don't sit there and walk around thinking, I'm doomed from the very beginning all the time. Is that really the way you want to live? I mean, let's just talk about a dreaded Monday here. Do you really want to be taking your last few breaths going, if I only would have done this, then it would have been so much better. I would have felt better. I would have had more joy in my life, more happiness. You see, because we're not taking these little things that we take for granted and we're not breaking it down. And it may not seem like much, but man, how many days are in the year? 365. And guess what? You're on day 13 right now. You do the math. Do you want to continue to have another, 50 weeks now of dreaded Mondays? Seriously? Answer that honestly for yourself. I know for me, I don't want that. Now, since I'm being very honest here, I am one who doesn't wake up most of the time dreaded. Seriously, I just don't. I'm a morning person. I get up happy. I am ready to go. But what does get in the way are the things that I feel like I have to convince myself that I must do. And it just depends on what those are. Sometimes it's my exercise. Shh, don't tell anybody. Sometimes I got to take the kids to school. Shh, I wish I could sleep in. It's those little things. But you know what? I can change my attitude towards them, how I see it. And I do. I flip the switch. I flip how I see it. I no longer see the color blue. I see the color purple when I'm looking at my exercise and what I need to do for that day. You know, some people love to run. I used to love to run. But if it's your turn to run that day and that's an exercise you hate, you're going to be like, I don't want to do it. And you're going to dread it. You're going to be like, oh, you're already bummed out before it even happens because you're thinking about it. Look at it differently. Change it up. What is one thing you can do to assist in feeling that way each day? You can't let the days of the week dictate your successes or what you can and will accomplish. And in the same manner, you can't let it dictate your failures. It goes both ways. You will act upon what is perceived both in your mind and in your heart. So what do you want out of life that you need to prepare for in a way in which you see and live out your everyday? What do you need to do? What needs to change? You see, this is the day that the Lord has made. There are no junk days unless you're proclaiming it as one. In my opinion, there are no junk days. You get to decide, junk day or joy day. Which will it be? Go out today, be present, be incredible, be you. And you know what? Find that joy day. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a gorgeous day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.